been asking for forgiveness, so forgive me for my faults. And I hope you never get this, and I send it to your door. Yeah, I've crossed that Mississippi at least 3 times before. No, no, without your love, I can't go back there no more. Said, oh no, without your love, I can't go back there no more. Locked up all your window.
All right, we finally made it to Piedmont, South Dakota, Jack's Campers. We're gonna be on a Bjerknes adventure to Yellowstone and Grand Teton. We rented this guy here. I'll give you a tour a little bit later inside. I'll give you a quick little sneak peek. Sneak peek. Anyway, we're just loading up, about to head out, and we'll keep you posted.
Wasted all my time. Said you.
We made it to our campsite. And look what we have right there. Devil's Tower.
You never get this for a long, long while.
Just got back from a nice bike ride, and now we're just kind of hanging out and looking at that beauty right there.
Food out of tin cans, it's one way you can live.
What you guys doing?
We're watching the show.
Watching Ryan the Last Train.
Is this where you guys are gonna stay tonight?
Yep.
At the bunk? TV right there too. We just got up to Devil's Tower parking. There's our big rig. There's Mama taking pictures too. We're gonna go check out Devil's Tower. We got in free because of Capri's a fourth grader and she's got a, what's it called, Capri? It's a national park pass. Nice.
And I got this.
Let's see it, bud. What do you have? Junior Range. Nice. Go check it out. Bucky, what do you think?
It's ginormous. It's so cool.
You like it, bud?
Yeah.
Do you wish you had shades?
Yeah.
Find some climbers up there. Right there.
Wasted all my time. Said you stole it and wasted all my time. Said you stole it and wasted all my time. Said you stole it and wasted all my time. Time, time. No, I hope you never get there.
To the mountains we go.
Got a beautiful view here in Wyoming. And we're kind of on the open road. Going pretty well, driving the 29 footer, and Mom's working in the back. It's kind of nice having full amenities wherever you drive. What do you think, Capri?
Pretty nice.
Nice. Yep, we're heading to the mountains, snow-capped mountains. Yellowstone and Grand Teton, Bjerknes adventure.
I belong a long way from here. Put on a poncho, played for mosquitoes and drank till I was thirsty again. We went searching through thrift store jungles. Found your animals right.
All right, we made it to our second camping spot. It might be really windy, hopefully not too bad. We drove about 5.5 hours today in the RV. Our RV is right back there, so we've got a really cool spot. This is Buffalo Bill State Park, I believe. And we had to get reserve spots today. So anyway, kind of tired today, but tomorrow we're gonna head to Yellowstone officially. And tonight we're just gonna kind of hang out and enjoy that beautiful view. And we kind of have the place to ourselves, it feels like. No one else is really out here. So hopefully it's not too windy for you.
Real low down. You listen to Coltrane, derail your own train. Well, who hasn't been there before? I come around, around the hard way. Bring your comics in bed, scrape the mold off the bread, and serve you French toast again. Well, okay, I still get stoned. I'm not the kind of girl you take home if it makes you happy. It can't be that bad.
All right, we're pulling up to the east entrance of Yellowstone, and we already see our first two bison. That's pretty cool.
Right there. What do you think?
They're really cool.
To get a picture?
Mm-hmm. I don't think they're wild.
To get a picture, Ben?
And we've got the Capri's in fourth grade, so we've got the annual pass free. So we've got a little card here.
They're wild, guys.
And I think we just have to hand it to the person and should be able to go right through. Good job, Capri. All right, we just pulled over for lunch. This is a pretty nice spot. What do you guys think of our lunch spot? Got the RV parked over on the side of the road. Good times. I love that sound.
Then why the hell are you so sad? If it makes you happy.
We've got mud volcanoes of some sort. What do you think, Baki?
So weird.
You smell it? Got a strong smell of sulfur. Bree, what do you think of that smell?
It's disgusting.
Glass. Gases rise furiously here.
Oh, now it's in the
pot. Yeah, did you see it?
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
Meet me on the mountain where the wind keeps blowing our blues away. Meet me on the mountain before we must be on our way. It's good to see you, my friend. Once again, though there never really seems to be very much time, there's something I wanna say, but I can't be with you today.
So why don't you meet me on that mountain in the morning light?
All right, we're just heading out the west entrance to Baker's. What's the campground, honey?
Baker's Hole.
Baker's Hole. They didn't have any spots available at Madison, so we're going outside the park. Yeah, in Yellowstone. So we're going just outside Yellowstone to Baker's and see if we have any luck there. So we'll keep you posted.
We're in West Yellowstone.
I've been down. I've been too long in this town. And every now and then I hear that old whistle cry. And if you're sad and feeling low, brother, I will share the load. Yeah, just meet me on that mountain way up high. Meet me on the mountain.
All right, we made it to Madison Campground in Yellowstone, right? It's in Yellowstone? And we kind of had a challenge today finding a camp spot, so that everything was booked. So we went out actually to, did we make it to Idaho? West
yes.
Yellowstone.
Yep, almost, yep.
West Yellowstone, about 45 minute drive, and everything was booked. So we came back, the gal here said that at 4 o'clock, come back. There might be some spots that open up that people didn't show. And we got the last spot available in the whole place, tents or anything. So we have a 29 foot RV and it was perfect, so we don't have to drive all over looking for a spot. So but we saw, what did we see today?
We saw
bison.
We saw a mama bear with two cubs, and we saw a elk,
a big elk with a nice set of horns. We saw countless bison.
Yeah, we found a bison.
A lot of bison. We had lunch.
Oh, and they were grizzly bears.
Were they grizzly?
Yeah,
brown bears for sure. Grizzlies possible. We had lunch on a river. It was beautiful. It was one of those pullouts. Now we're just kind of hanging out. We had supper tonight and enjoying the fire.
We went to the Grand Canyon of Yellowstone and saw the falls.
That was
lower
pretty
falls.
Nice.
That's, I think, two or three times as high as Niagara Falls. That was pretty pretty.
But we'll check in tomorrow.
And I spend all my days drinking, so I don't have to spend.
This is the Old Faithful Inn, built entirely of timbers and wood. So cool.
You got me walking 10 miles high. Step up.
What was that called, the beehive or the bee? Little bee? They're getting wet over there. This one happens every 12 hours.
My best guess is too far off, and in my chest the rhythm's gone, and all of the rest falls to the side. sit alone in an empty house, writing notes while I'm thinking about nothing.
You got this, and then it gets better.
We're leaving the south entrance of Yellowstone and we're going to be heading into Grand Teton National Park next.
Step off, see if I can fly.
For a moment I could wait to see it fall apart. Every empty bed in every city I've been, I sit and contemplate all the moments you said.
All right, we made it to Grand Teton National Park. We are currently in Colter Bay?
Colter Bay
Campground. And we got lucky once again. Came rolling in, the park was full, reservation only. We were very nice and asked the lady, who was Jen from Florida, shout out to Jen, she actually gave us one of the last spots that were available. You okay, bud? Last spots that are available, and so we've got a nice spot, no plug-ins or anything, but that was fine. Instead of having to drive all over looking for a spot, we were happy to find one here in Colter Bay. It's a great place. We woke up, and what did we do this morning?
We went to Old Faithful first thing. We left the campground about 7 o'clock, a little before 7. Went to Old Faithful, saw it erupt, walked around the geysers. Then we went over to Grand Prismatic Spring. That was beautiful. We did the hike, Fairy Falls hike.
Got to see it from way up top, kind of the down view of it, which
it
is beautiful.
Super cool.
Yeah. And then we drove south down to Teton. We went past Lewis Falls, and
Lewis Falls was really cool.
Kids like that, just fun. A little spot on the side of the road, but really, a really neat little spot. And then we stopped at the beginning of Jackson Lake, just kind of a side of the road thing again, and the kids played in the water. And then we came down to the campground, and then
basically from there we went and ate at, what was the place called? Colter Bay restaurant of some sort, and it was a sit-down restaurant. That was nice. And then we came back, got our bikes, went for a nice long bike ride to check out the campground, and now we're back enjoying a beautiful fire. So anyway, tomorrow, where are we heading tomorrow?
Tomorrow we're going to Jenny Lake for
Jenny
spring.
Lake.
We hear it's kind of busy, so we're going to try to be there about 7 o'clock again. So
we'll be up and at them and take off, and hopefully be in the parking lot because we have a spot, because the parking lot's small, I was told. So what do you have to say, Capri? Okay. What's your favorite thing today?
I like Grand Prismatic and the beehole.
The beehive?
Beehive.
That's the other
by Old Faith.
Old Faith geyser. It only goes off every 12 hours and we got to see it today. So
yes.
Awesome. Alright, we'll keep you posted.
Favorite part?
I also like those two. And also I like when you went in the water at that one.
Yeah. And the beach right
yep.
over
there's
here.
A beach here at Colter Bay. It's a rock beach. The kids liked it. And there's a beautiful view of the mountains. So anyway, we'll keep you posted for tomorrow.
I got a rice cooking in the microwave. Got a 3-day beard I don't plan to shave. And it's a goofy thing, but I just gotta say, hey, I'm a doing all right.
Pack it on. Anything you bring with you back in the backcountry, make sure any garbage comes back on. Even like a banana peel or an apple core, just anything at all needs to come off and you come back on. The last boat today is going to be at 7 o'clock, so if you're going to go for a longer hike today, remember that. We'll be running boats all day long, every 15 minutes or so. We have 4 boats running today, so they'll all be running by within 1 hour. So. If you're gonna walk back where we just started from, it's 2.5 miles around the south end of the lake. Just keep the lake kind of left. If you wanna go the other way around the lake, it's a 5-mile walk.
It's been 15 years since I left home. I said good luck to every seed I'd sown. Give it my best and then I left it alone. I hope they're doing alright. Now I look in the mirror and what do I see? A long wolf there staring back at me. Long in the tooth but harmless as can be. Lord, I guess he's doing alright. And it's a great day to be alive. I know the sun's still shining when I close my eyes. There's some hard times in the neighborhood, but why can't every day this good? Sometimes it's lonely, sometimes it's only me and the shadows that fill this room. Sometimes I'm falling, desperately calling, howling out. Tattoo. I'll take my old Harley for a 3-day cruise. Might even grow me a Fu Manchu.
Now we're at String Lake. It's supposed to be like a little swimming area, but I'm sure the water is cold. Jenny Lake was at 50 degrees.
Hard times in the neighborhood, but why can't every day be just this good? It's a great day. Some hard times in the neighborhood, but why can't every day be just this good?
Teton Village Trail Rides. We're going to go on a horseback ride in Jackson Hole.
We're pretty pumped. Initially, we weren't going to be able to get a horse, or actually be able to go, but now we are.
Every day.
Snipping and a snarling and a carrying on, thinking he had that track right where he wanted him. I'm telling you, he was a mean little dog.
Every day in 100 different ways, I make the choice to stay. I can hit the open road, run my life away, but I choose you.
Whitewater rafting time. Back up, Capri. You excited for the whitewater rafting adventure?
Excited. Scared, excited, and nervous.
Think you're gonna fall out? Float down the river? I'll save ya.
My little talk. Right around then, we'll be at our first class one rapid, and we'll have a good mile of class one before we start hitting class two. And then we have a couple miles of class two before we hit class three. Our first class three is the biggest rapid of the day. It's called the lunch counter, and that's at mile five or so. And then following lunch counter, there's two more class threes that are also very fun at this water level. So it's an exciting trip. It gets more fun as we get further downstream.
Beach is dear. And drink from prism stream so clear. You don't have to be rich to get around. There are mansions growing out of the ground. Days go by. Get out and see the world. Days go by. Get out and see the world with your own eyes. Now the journey took you far from home. Pushed you out of your comfort zone. There are kids out there with war paint on and hearts break like crayon.
What do you think, Beck and John?
I just wanted to make it through.
Stage three rapid, Beck?
All right.
I was holding on like that. I was like, ah!
Good breathe. You look pretty dry back there.
What?
Bad things in a very shallow. And cries for help with no echo. Days go by. Get out and see the world. Days go by. Get out and see the world with your own eyes. It's hard to see what you're going through. On you. You'll spend some time in the waiting place, and the purest things may leave no trace. Go up the mountain top and shine. I reflected on my long decline. I've gathered sunsets in my prime. I'll never climb. Days go by.